Over the ages, comets have been seen as bad omens. People believed one comet portended the assassination of Julius Caesar, and another, the Black Death in medieval England.
During the Middle Ages, comets were thought of as warning signs, missiles shot at a sinful earth from the right hand of an avenging god.
Some cultures depicted them as blazing swords, slashing the nocturnal sky as an expression of divine wrath. But by the 17th century, astronomers were beginning to understand the true nature of comets as physical objects, rather than supernatural creatures or apparitions. Using Isaac Newton's techniques, British astronomer Edmund Halley calculated the orbits of 24 comets.
Halley was the first to note, along with his colleague Newton, that comets are celestial objects. They're in orbit around the sun, just like the planets, except they're on very elongated orbits, so they can cross the Earth's orbit once on the way in and once on the way out.
Halley boldly announced that three of them, the ones seen in 1531, 1607, and 1682, were the same comet on its periodic visits to Earth. He predicted that the comet would return every 76 years, and he was right. Halley's comet did return in 1758, as it has done roughly every 76 years since. Halley's discovery changed the status of comets from mystical omen to real and physical threat.
The fear of comets was sort of transferred from a sign of an impending disaster, some sort of an apparition, to objects that actually could hit the Earth. So we went from warning shots to actual missiles.
One of those missiles might have changed the world 4,800 years ago. And experts think that another deadly missile could strike Earth with very little warning. Since its birth 4.6 billion years ago, Earth has been pummeled by thousands of comets and asteroids. Scientists think that such impacts may have caused two or more of five global extinctions. The latest one, 65 million years ago, is thought to have killed more than 75% of the living organisms on Earth, including the dinosaurs. These major cosmic strikes seem to occur at very long intervals. 4,800 years ago, a comet may have killed more than 50% of the population. Ironically, many scientists believe that comets may have brought to Earth the basic elements that make life possible. During the time it was being formed, the planet was very hot and very dry. So the question that has long puzzled scientists is, where did our water come from? One theory is that comets striking Earth billions of years ago provided the water that would eventually make up the planet's oceans and seas. In the year 2000, Comet Linear broke apart as it passed by the Sun. Infrared spectrum analysis revealed that the comet was likely made up of water in the form of ice. Some scientists believe that comets may have also dispersed complex organic molecules that could have become the first cell membranes on Earth.
Comets came in and provided much of the water that's in our oceans today and much of the water that's in our bodies today. And comets may also have brought to the early Earth much of the carbon-based molecules that is necessary for life. So without cometary bombardments, it's unlikely that life would have formed on Earth. And so we owe our very existence to these objects.
Could a massive comet crash into Earth again? Someday, this science fiction scenario could become a devastating reality. Based on data gathered by Dr. Dallas Abbott and calculations performed with the University of Arizona's Impact Effect Calculator program, it might unfold like this. A comet started its journey millions of years ago on the distant edge of our solar system. It is now near Jupiter. The stealthy ancient traveler, awakened by the approaching sun, starts jetting dust and gases from its icy nucleus. It is 4 months away from its target, Earth. 2 a.m. at the Mauna Kea Observatories in Hawaii. Astronomers identify the faint optical signature of what may be a new comet. As dim as Comet McNaught's image when it was discovered in 2006. Other astronomers around the world confirm the sighting. It is a new comet, and it is approaching Mars fast. The Minor Planet Center in Cambridge, Massachusetts begins to calculate its orbit. It will take scientists a couple of months or more to determine if it could hit Earth. Near Mars's orbit, the traveler is now a dazzling sight, with a growing tail of light dashing toward Earth at over 50,000 miles per hour. It is confirmed. The object is a long-period comet with a trajectory that will cause it to hit Earth in 30 days. Alerts are sent all over the world, but time is running out. Governments and international space and military organizations scramble to decide on a course of action.
It's technologically much more difficult to deal with a comet than it is an asteroid.
Shooting it down is not an option. It may compound the problem by creating a collection of fragments. Diverting its trajectory with a spacecraft is not possible. There is not enough time to prepare and launch such a mission. Now, about 2 million miles away from Earth, the comet speeds at more than 100,000 miles per hour. Scientists narrow the probable impact zone to an offshore area near San Francisco. The comet is about to collide with our planet's most effective shield, the atmosphere, but it will provide no defense at all.
So a large comet, several miles in diameter, would simply punch right through the atmosphere, and it wouldn't matter that the comet is fragile and underdense and porous.
Bridges and freeways are jammed as a panicked population tries to flee the city, but it is too late. The 3-mile-wide comet hits the Pacific Ocean, 100 miles west of San Francisco. With more than 30 million megatons of energy.
When it impacts the ocean surface, it's going to essentially vaporize the water almost immediately.
The impact unleashes a blast of thermal radiation toward the city.
You're talking about minimum of temperatures around 1500 Kelvin. So anyone who's outside when that event occurs would essentially be vaporized almost.
Wooden structures, dry grass, and brush all ignite in a flash. Flames burst out around the city. As more than 7 million people in the Bay Area are scorched by the lethal heat, a 9.0 earthquake caused by the comet's impact shatters structures and buildings all over San Francisco. The Bay Bridge collapses. The Golden Gate Bridge yields to the inexorable power of nature. Entire districts in the city cave in as the ground liquefies under their foundations. Cracks appear on the ground, transforming the landscape. As the minutes tick by in slow motion, 3-inch fragments of debris from the seafloor pummel the defenseless city. In the midst of chaos and destruction, a moment of eerie silence precedes the sonic bang. The deafening air blast breaks through at more than 4 times the speed of sound, destroying whatever was left standing.